Assalamu alaikum everyone. Welcome to the online session of clinical examination for FCPS Cardiology 2020. I am Dr. Haseeb Raza and I am working as Cardiac Electrophysiology Fellow at the National Institute of Cardiovascular Diseases, Karachi. Today we are going to discuss short case of patent ductus arteriosus. Very commonly asked questions. We are going to discuss about all those questions. And for this discussion, I have invited a special speaker. His name is Dr. Naveen Roy, and he is working as Fellow of Interventional Cardiology at National Institute of Cardiovascular Diseases, Karachi. Assalamu alaikum, Dr. Naveen. Kaise hain aap?
Walaikum assalam. Walaikum assalam. Dr. Haseeb, aap kaise hain? Aapki tabiyat theek hai?
Alhamdulillah, Allah ka bada karam hai. Thank you so much for giving us your precious time. Bade short notice pe aapne jo hai meri call uthai aur mujhe mayus nahi kiya.
It's my pleasure. It's always talking good to talk with a young cardiologist. It's always a pleasure.
That's right. ये आपकी बात है जो हम जो है ना हमेशा फिर आपको खींच कर निकाल लाते हैं लैब से बाहर निकाल लेते हैं आपको.
बहुत शुक्रिया, बहुत शुक्रिया.
So for participants, हमेशा की तरह मैसेज यही है कि आप क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर जो हमारा पैनल है उसके अंदर अपने क्वेश्चंस थ्रो कर सकते हैं और एट द एंड ऑफ द टॉक आपके जितने भी सवाल आते हैं उनके जवाब हम लेने की कोशिश करेंगे डॉक्टर नवीन से. सो डॉक्टर नवीन, माइक जो है वो मैं आपकी तरफ करता हूँ. यू कैन स्टार्ट शेयरिंग योर प्रेजेंटेशन और जितना भी आपको टाइम चाहिए, इट इज ऑल ओवर टू यू. Please go ahead.
Assalamu alaikum, my fellow colleagues. My name is Dr. Naveen Roy. I am working as an intervention cardiology fellow at National Institute of Cardiovascular Disease, Karachi. Well, today is very interesting topic, though the rare one. Maybe most of you haven't seen a case if you are working in some hospitals, and maybe some of you have seen many cases of PDA. So we will discuss in a bit. I will answer your queries at the end of this section, and I hope that you will get something from it. So, so if you cannot do great things, just do the small things in a great way. So regarding short case, it will create an impression of you on examiner. So first impression is the last impression, because you will be dealing long cases maybe sooner or later, but your short cases may have an impact on your examiner. So that's what most of the students think, most of the candidate think, that the examiner will be happy to irritate us. But now the process has changed in the College of Physician Surgeon Pakistan. If you are confident, if you have knowledge, you can convey your knowledge, you can apply your knowledge, believe me, you can pass easily. The CPSP exam is not as hard as we think. So it's my humble request to all the candidates, be confident. Whatever knowledge you have, believe me, you have the best knowledge. Even the examiner don't have this kind of knowledge which you have at the examination day. So give your best. So PDA, what is PDA? It's a ductus arteriosus, a fetal communication between the descending aorta. So it's a fetal communication between the descending aorta just distal to the subclavian artery and the main pulmonary artery before its bifurcation. So PDA occurs when the ductus arteriosus fail to close and regress after birth to form ligamentum arteriosum. So what's the fate of ductus arteriosus? Normally, it closes or become functionally insignificant within the 15 to 18 hours after the birth. So one thing, then what after the birth, or what are 15 hours after the birth? So wait for 3 months in a term infant, because it normally closes within the 3 months in the term infant and up to 12 months in the preterm infant. So we have to wait for 3 months to 1 year in order for PDA to close itself. I'm sorry, it's not changing.
I think due to some internet connection, thoda sa delay aata hai slide change hone ke andar.
So it's a diagrammatic representation of the PDA. Diagrammatic representation in which the arrow here, you can appreciate the aorta, and this is a pulmonary artery. So this is the defect. So normally it became insignificant after 15 to 18 hours after the birth, as I have already mentioned. So the question arises, what's the ideal time for surgery in babies? So it's a large defect and symptomatic, such as poor weight gain, fast breathing, even before 6 months, one can close. But if asymptomatic, it can go up to the adult life. So why PDA is important? Because in the early life, in the fetal circulation, there's an increased resistance by lungs and constricted arterioles. So blood will be directed toward the aorta. But soon after birth, lungs become functional and it produces prostaglandins. So it follows the normal pathway. Regarding the risk factors for the development of PDA, it's a premature birth, family history, and other genetic conditions. So if an offspring has a disease, it's 3% chances are there to transfer into the offspring. Rubella infection during pregnancy is one of the risk factors to have development of the PDA. Being born at a high altitude and female sex has a higher is a risk factor. So this is a classification popularly known as Tichenko angiographic classification of the PDA, in which there is a, if you concentrate on this type E conical, type A, which is called conical, this is constructed near the pulmonary insertion. If you can appreciate the blue here, it is constructed. This is called a type A conical type. Regarding type B, it's a short with narrowing on the aortic side. So here it is. Regarding type C, it's a tubular without any constriction. You can appreciate there is no constriction. Regarding type D, it's called complex and it has a multiple constriction. And regarding type E, it's elongated. So remember, this is the angiographic classification. Regarding type E, it's elongated, long PDA with a conical shape, and it has a multiple constriction. So talking about the natural history, what's the natural history of PDA? It's a popularly asked question in the examination. So it basically depends upon the three things. So this is the size of the PDA, whether it's large or small, whether it's symptomatic or asymptomatic. Importantly, direction of the shunt, whether it's left to right or the right to left, and any associated complication like ASD, transposition of Gray's arteries. So it's all depend on these three factors. So what about PDA if it is untreated? So if it's untreated, one third people die till the age of 40. And two-thirds die till the age of 60. So when there is volume overload, patient may complain of congestive heart failure, sinus symptoms of congestive heart failure. Ultimately, lead to right to left shunt and Eisenmenger syndrome. So natural history comprises of size of the PDA, direction of the shunt, and any associated complication associated with the PDA. So regarding size, it can also be calculated by the right heart cath using the formula QPQS interval. So I don't want to go into the details of that. I know everybody should know the formula and they must be knowing and know how to calculate it. So if it's a small, is less than 1.5, is a moderate 1.5 to 2.2. And if it's large, is more than 2.2. So another way to calculate the size it's important because in order to deploy the devices, the silent PDA is less than 1.5, you may not appreciate the murmur. Very small PDA is less than 1.5 with audible murmur. A small PDA is 1.5 to 3 milliper murmur, and large, moderate and large, large definitely is more than 5 mm. So size is determined by the minimal ductal diameter. I will show later on how it can be calculated on the lateral scintigraphy. So this is the angiographic views. Here we can calculate size, basically defining the anatomy of the PDA. Now left lateral projection is the best view as already shown for the sizing of the devices. If you are closing the PDA with the devices, it's the best view in order to close the device. Certain projection as LAO 60 profile for the PDA and RAO 30 for the ampullae direction. Now, if you concentrate on two figures, these are both the lateral projection, figure A and figure B. These figures are for measurement of the minimal ductal diameter. If you can see the this line, white line, is calculating the minimal ductal diameter, and this is measuring the ductal ampulla. Now, if you concentrate on the figure B, it's a minimal ductal diameter again, and this is calculating the length. So this is how we calculate the size of the devices. It's best calculated again in the left lateral position. So regarding signs and symptoms, there may be no signs and symptoms if the PDA is small and it gets unnoticed until patient reach adulthood, or if the large PDA is found, maybe someone has a breathlessness, palpitations, peripheral edema, etc. So this was a theory. Examiner may ask any of the questions already mentioned here. Now let's concentrate on the examination findings. The first thing you will do after an informed consent and proper exposure. So starting from the pulses, you may feel a bounding pulse, a high volume pulse as you feel in the AR. Regarding the blood pressure, you may find wild pulse pressure. Why there is a wild pulse pressure? Because of the mild systolic increase in the systolic blood pressure and diastolic runoff flow in the PDA. Regarding jugular venous pressure, it may be normal, and most of the time it's normal. But if associated with the volume overload, then you may find the prominent A wave because of the atrial contraction and the prominent V wave because of the atrial filling during diastole. So regarding palpation, it can be a normal, or it may be laterally displaced because of the hyperactive left ventricular impulse. So palpation along the left upper sternal border may reveal systolic pulsation of the pulmonary artery in patient with large left to right shunt, which basically demonstrates signs of volume overload. So the displaced hyperactive left ventricular impulse demonstrate patient having left ventricular volume overload. Apex beat may be displaced and thrusting when again when the left ventricular dimension are increased. So talking about the heart sound, S1 can be normal, S2 can be obscured by the murmur, but if there is pulmonary hypertension, definitely you will find a P2 loud, and then there may be a reverse splitting. So pathognomic, there is harsh continuous murmur at the left first or second intercostal space with a systolic acetylation. This is called the Gibson murmur. You may appreciate mid-diastolic apical murmur because of the increased flow towards the mitral valve. And if pulmonary hypertension is present, then you find all the findings, for example, parasternal heave, parasternal thrill, and the loud P2. But the most important sign, again, is a differential cyanosis. Now, why there is a differential cyanosis? Because the increased desaturated blood from the duct enters the aorta distal to the subclavian artery, sparing the brachiocephalic circulation. So you may find red hand with the blue toes. I want you to concentrate on this sound, continuous murmur. आवाज आ रही है सबको?
Yes, we can hear you.
That's good. No, I'm talking about the continuous murmur sound.
Yes, yes.
Is everyone hearing?
That is also audible.
Oh, that's good, that's good. So I again want you to listen again. I will play again. So I will play once again, just to concentrate on the continuous murmur again at the different areas of the pericardium. So moving to the differential diagnosis, I hope everyone has listened. So examiner will ask you, what's the differential diagnosis? So why I have put the slide of continuous murmur, because your the whole examination will depend on the just single finding. You may appreciate differential cyanosis and clubbing, but this is the main finding. So from venous hump, you have to differentiate the PDA. So how will you differentiate it? Venous hump is located more on the right side. It's heard at the right of the sternum. Again, it decreases in supine position. So it's murmur decrease in supine position, expiration and compression of the right jugular vein. So talking about the coronary artery fistula, it again, it's a continuous murmur, but because of the phasic flow, it's louder in the systole. Now talking about the systemic coronary artery fistula, again, it's located over the lower pericardium. Regarding aortic stenosis with ASD and AR, again, its murmur has a brief pause. Its murmur end at with S2 and it's a brief pause. Again, then the diastolic murmur start. There's one differential diagnosis. There's a ruptured sinus of Valsalva. It's heard over the lower pericardium, loudest at the sternal edge, and it can be increased in the systole. So ECG can be normal. It may show left atrial enlargement, left ventricular hypertrophy, right atrial enlargement, or right ventricular hypertrophy. It's a non-specific. One may cannot find any of the, these things. Regarding chest X-ray, it can be again normal, or you may appreciate the enlargement already mentioned in the ECG. If there's right to left shunt, pulmonary hypertension, maybe pulmonary artery enlarged, or maybe calcification of the PDA in the older people, calcifying the artery. So best modality, echo, transthoracic echo, 42% sensitivity and 100% specificity. The best view is suprasternal notch view. Again, color Doppler and continuous wave Doppler help determine the direction flow in the PDA. Diastolic aortic flow reversal is seen in descending aorta shunt is significant. So if you can appreciate, this is the pulmonary artery, the descending aorta, here is the PDA. Not clear visualize, but if you can concentrate on the right side, there is a colored turbulent. So this is the PDA. This is the suprasternal short axis. And this is the parasternal short axis view. This is the aorta, mean pulmonary artery, left pulmonary artery, and this is the PDA and descending aorta. So here you can appreciate the color turbulence here. This is the PDA. So this can be asked in the talks. These two diagram are been taken from the previous talks. So regarding echo, transesophageal echo if the transthoracic echo is inconclusive because it has an increased sensitivity. Otherwise, there is no role of transesophageal echo. Cardiac catheterization really needed for the diagnostic purpose. PD is best demonstrated by the descending aortogram performed in the lateral projection, which I have already mentioned you. So this is again, I've already shown the PD, a mean pulmonary artery. There's a descending aorta, and this is a communication. It's called PDA. This is the AP view again, the main pulmonary artery, descending aorta, and the PDA. So MRI CT scan for defining unusual anatomy and associated lesion. Otherwise, there is no need to perform these modalities. This is one of the questions came in talks, I think 3 to 4 years back, in which they have asked about the which structures you are seeing and what's the diagnosis and is associated with which lesions. So if you appreciate here, this is PDA, aorta, pulmonary artery. So it's associated with different types of lesion. For example, VSD, transposition of great arteries. So regarding treatments, we have three options. Medical therapy for those who have developed the symptoms in advanced stage. Otherwise, medical therapy is only for the neonates. Regarding percutaneous closures, we have different options regarding coils and ADO devices. If they are small, can be closed through coils. If size is more than 35 mm, can be closed with the ADO. And we have another option, surgical option, which is more in the neonates. So regarding guidelines, American Heart Association says it's a class 1 indication if the PDA is closed in, if the left atrial or left ventricular enlargement is there, or there is a pulmonary artery systolic pressure is less than 50% of the systemic, or pulmonary vascular resistance is less than 1/3 of the systemic. Regarding 2B and 3, 3 is important. PDA closure should not be performed, as we already know, if there is right to left shunt with a irreversible pulmonary vascular resistance. So European Society of Cardiology has updated their guidelines last year. Class 1 indication, again, PDA should be closed in a patient with sign of LV volume overload, already mentioned in the American Heart Association guidelines. PDA should be closed in a patient with pulmonary artery hypertension, but pulmonary artery pressure should be less than 2/3 of the systemic, already mentioned, or pulmonary vascular resistance less than 2/3 of the systemic vascular resistance. And device closure is the method of choice. So before even surgery, device is a method of choice. Regarding class 2A, 2A device closure should be considered in small PDA with continuous murmur, normal LV and pulmonary artery pressure. PDA closure should be avoided in the Eisenmenger and patient with exercise induced low volume desaturation. This is a class 3 indication. Regarding follow-up, transthoracic echo at 6 months if duct closure is demonstrated immediately after the procedure. And every 2 to 3 months if there is residual defect. So make every possible efforts to close the PDA. Then the annual follow-up thereafter. There are a few complications, congestive heart failure, infective endocarditis, pulmonary hypertension, atrial fibrillation, and last but not the least is Eisenmenger syndrome. Now, how to approach this case? First of all, after reading the command, you have to act accordingly. If asks you to examine the precordium, you have to act accordingly. Are there evidence of infective endocarditis? Is there any stigmata of infective endocarditis you have to rule out in a patient with a PDA? For example, splinter hemorrhages are there, Osler nodes are there, Janeway lesions are there or not. Second, clubbing and cyanosis. You have to rule out clubbing and cyanosis. Regarding pulse, you have to mention the beats per minute, whether it's a regular or irregular atrial fibrillation is there or not, large volume with a coalescing character or not. And you have to measure the blood pressure. In this case, it's very important because you can appreciate wide pulse pressure. You can get an idea that this might be a patient of PDA. Regarding JVP, it can be a normal or maybe elevated if there is right-sided heart failure. On examination, precordium, there is a scar or not, where you can appreciate. If there is parasternal heave or left subclavicular thrill, if there is pulmonary hypertension, apex B, is it displaced, and what's the quality, is it thrusting or not? Regarding on auscultation, there is a murmur with systolic auscultation, left subclavicular area, you know, left first and second intercostal space. It will be as loud on the back of the, in between the scapula, and the lung fields are clear if there is sacral or peripheral edema or not. So this is how we will approach a case of PDA. So stigmata of the endocarditis, sinusitis clubbing, pulse, blood pressure, JVP, precordium, right-sided heart failure sign, apex beat sign, auscultation, murmur, and the back lung fields. So this is how you will provide the final diagnosis. My diagnosis most probably is PDA with left to right shunt or right to left shunt, whatever you find. The clinical sign of pulmonary hypertension are there or not, and the sign of left ventricle enlargement is present or not, left ventricle failure is present or not. So regarding examination tips, short case, you should be well-dressed. You should have a confident approach. You should be fully equipped with your equipments. You have to follow the command. Please understand the command first. Then you have to follow the command. Take a proper consent and a proper exposure. Make a systematic approach. Make approach from now onwards. Whatever approach you like, whether you start from the hand, whether you start from the eye, make a systematic approach. Don't try to complete the task before time. Make sure you utilize your 5 minutes so that you can think what I have to say, how will you compile the things. Give last 30 seconds to 1 minute to compile and think what you will say. If examiner is saying you to think or examine again, don't argue. It means you are missing something. This is a clue. So re-examine and rethink and then say. So these are the important questions. One can be asked, what's the differential cyanosis and reverse differential cyanosis, and what are their reasons? So differential cyanosis mean upper body will be pink and the lower body toes will be blue. So what are the causes? Preductal coarctation of aorta with PDA, interrupted aortic arch, pulmonary hypertension, VSD and PDA. So what do you mean by reverse differential cyanosis? So the upper body will be blue and the lower body will be pink. It's seen in the transposition of great arteries with coarctation of aorta and PDA. Which factor causes the functional and anatomical closure of ductus arteriosus? So the thrombosis, intimal proliferations, and fibrosis. What are the important risk factors for PDA? As I already mentioned, rubella infection, high altitude, female, gender, genetic conditions. Which conditions depend upon patency of PDA for survival? This is the most important questions. Examiner do ask about this. So the hypoplastic left heart, coarctation of aorta preductal type, and complete TGA. They need PDA for their survival in order to have oxygenated. Time period in which ductus arteriosus close normally, already explained 15 to 18 hours. Or in preterm infant, we can wait for 1 year, and term infant, we can wait for 3 months. Association of PDA, already mentioned, transposition of great arteries, coarctation of aorta, VSD, pulmonary hypertension. What's the common cause of heart failure in preterm infants? It's PDA, having congestive heart failure. So trust yourself. You know more than you think you do. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Naveen. That was a wonderful presentation. Aapne almost sari jo main jo baatein hain, PDA se related sari, शेयर करती हैं. क्वेश्चंस भी सारे जहाँ से आपके साथ क्रॉस क्वेश्चनिंग शुरू होती है कैंडिडेट के साथ, वो भी आपने इसके अंदर बता दिया है. वी हैव अ कपल ऑफ क्वेश्चंस फॉर यू, सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम आई विल स्टार्ट द क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर सेशन. क्वेश्चन इज हाउ टू डिफरेंशिएट पीडीए विद पल्मोनरी हाइपरटेंशन फ्रॉम pulmonary stenosis clinically on examination. Dr. Mohammed Awais hai. The question hai ki agar ek patient hai jisko PDA ke saath pulmonary hypertension hai, usko hum kaise differentiate karenge pulmonary stenosis ke saath clinically?
Acha, pulmonary stenosis ka jo murmur hai wo back pe loud nahi hoga, posteriorly. Even PDA ka murmur, it will be as loud posteriorly as anteriorly. So one can differentiate with this findings. Continuous murmur hoga, but it won't be loud on posterior side.
Okay, theek. Anonymous attendee hai ji, wo puch rahe hain, how do we confirm that P2 is loud? if it is heard at mitral area. How do we know that the sound we are hearing at the mitral area is not actually A2? आपको समझ आया क्वेश्चन?
नहीं, can you repeat again?
हाँ, वो एक्चुअली पूछना चाह रहे हैं कि अगर मैं ऑस्कल्टेट कर रहा हूँ माइटल एरिया को, ठीक है, तो माइटल एरिया पे मुझे सेकंड हार्ट साउंड के बारे में कैसे पता चलेगा कि उसकी डेंसिटी ज्यादा है या नहीं है?
नहीं, डिपेंड, अगर पल्मोनरी हाइपरटेंशन है, यू विल हैव अ पी2 लाउड एट द पल्मोनरी एरिया, नॉट एट द माइटल एरिया, अगर पल्मोनरी हाइपरटेंशन है.
सही.
अदरवाइज तो मुश्किल है टू डिफरेंशिएट.
यूजुअली इस तरह से होता है कि आप माइटल एरिया के ऊपर फर्स्ट हार्ट साउंड पे कमेंट करते हैं और फिर
बिल्कुल
जो अपने अपने एरियाज हैं उनके, पल्मोनरी एरिया और एओर्टिक एरिया, वहां पर उनके मुताबिक जो एओर्टिक कंपोनेंट है और पल्मोनरी कंपोनेंट है उस पे कमेंट करते हैं.
बिल्कुल.
डॉक्टर मरियम पूछ रही हैं, डू वी हैव टू चेक ऑक्सीजन सैचुरेशन विद पल्स ऑक्सीमीटर?
ना 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 ना, देयर इज नो नीड टू चेक पल्स ऑक्सीजन सैचुरेशन इन द शॉर्ट केस.
हाँ, इसकी जरूरत नहीं है. ठीक, बिल्कुल सही है. डॉक्टर आमिर रशीद पूछ रहे हैं, इनिशियली देयर विल बी डिफरेंशियल साइनोसिस, बट वंस आइजनमेंगर डेवलप्स, साइनोसिस विल बी एविडेंट इन ऑल फोर लिम्स?
या मे बी मे बी मे बी.
ठीक ठीक. डॉक्टर आमिर रशीद कह रहे हैं कि सर काइंडली शेयर दिस प्रेजेंटेशन. तो मैं डॉक्टर नवीन से पूछूंगा बाद में कि इफ ही एग्रीज तो मैं उनसे प्रेजेंटेशन लेकर इसको
सर. ऑल योर्स, ऑल योर्स.
चलें, जबरदस्त, इजाजत मिल गई है, गुड. डॉक्टर सालिक नज़ीर पूछ रहे हैं, सलाम एवरीवन, डॉक्टर नवीन काइंडली कंफर्म द एग्जैक्ट डेफिनेशन ऑफ वाइट पल्स प्रेशर. ये कह रहे हैं जी, वाइट पल्स प्रेशर जो है उसकी सबसे अच्छी डेफिनेशन क्या हो सकती है? मतलब कोई है, कोई लिटरेचर के अंदर
डेफिनेशन इन द सेंस इज बेसिकली द सिस्टोलिक कंपोनेंट माइनस द डायस्टोलिक कंपोनेंट. सो इन दिस वे यू कैन कैलकुलेट द पल्स प्रेशर, बट दैट्स अ डेफिनेशन इन द सेंस कि एग्जामिनर विल आस्क व्हाट द मे आस्क व्हाट्स द पल्स प्रेशर. यू कैन से भाई इट्स द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द सिस्टोलिक एंड द डायस्टोलिक प्रेशर, दैट्स इट.
सही, ओके ओके. एनोनिमस अटेंडी पूछ रहे हैं, इफ इन फर्स्ट इन द फर्स्ट गो वी आर नॉट पिकिंग कंटीन्यूअस मर्मर, कैन वी चेक द पल्स एंड देन अगेन ऑस्कल्टेट टू कंफर्म आवर डायग्नोसिस, विल इट गिव अ बैड इंप्रेशन?
वेल, इफ यू हैवंट अंडरस्टैंड द कमांड दैट इट विल गिव द बैड इंप्रेशन.
ओके ओके.
एग्जामिन द प्रीकॉर्डियम and relevant until and unless you haven't auscultated the precordium, you haven't appreciated the continuous murmur, then what you will see in the pulse? Nothing.
Dr. Amina Azhar pooch rahi hai ke what are the differentials of differential cyanosis? Ki agar aap differential cyanosis dekh rahe hain पेशेंट पे, तो डिफरेंशियल साइनोसिस के मतलब क्या डीडीज बन सकती हैं?
अच्छा, आई हैव ऑलरेडी मेंशन द प्रीडक्टल कॉक्टेशन एओर्टा विद पीडीए, देयर इज अ इंटररप्टेड एओर्टिक आर्च एंड पीडीए विद वीएसडी.
ठीक, बिल्कुल ठीक है. डॉक्टर सिद्रा आमिर कह रही हैं कि वेरी वेल एक्सप्लेन्ड सर, प्लीज एलैबोरेट अ बिट मोर ऑन टाइमिंग ऑफ सर्जरी.
वेल, टाइमिंग ऑफ सर्जरी डिपेंड्स a patient is symptomatic or asymptomatic. So one can wait for 6 months to 1 year. As I've already mentioned, if the preterm infant, you can wait for the 1 year. If there is a term infant, you can wait for the 3 months. Again, providing the fact patient is asymptomatic. If it's symptomatic, so you can repair surgical, you can have surgical repair within 3 months or within 6 months.
Okay. Dr. Naveen, can you check your camera? Because your video is not coming.
वीडियो अनफॉर्चुनेटली फिर आती है. अभी आ रही है?
नहीं, अभी नहीं आ रही. आप ट्राई कीजिएगा, अगर आती है तो ठीक है, आई विल कंटिन्यू विद द क्वेश्चंस. डॉक्टर मतीन पूछ रहे हैं कि ओके, नाइस प्रेजेंटेशन सर, वन क्वेश्चन, इफ कमांड इज टू एग्जामिन प्रीकॉर्डियम, देन आफ्टर एग्जामिनिंग प्रीकॉर्डियम वी हैव टू टेक परमिशन फ्रॉम एग्जामिनर, for peripheral examination, or we can proceed anyway?
No, you don't have to proceed. You have to take permission. If the command is examine the precordium, you have to just examine the precordium. For confirming your diagnosis, or if you are in a doubt, you can ask examiner, I want to check the pulse, or I want to check the relevant findings. If he or she say yes, then you have to proceed. Otherwise, stop there.
Okay. Dr. Imran Ali pooch rahe hain ke how much knowledge we need regarding the devices. Should we know different types and their mechanisms and the procedure?
So there are two things. If you are studying for the exam, I don't think so you have to learn. If you want to become a good cardiologist, good intervention cardiologist or whatever you are in the field, and if some junior asks you about the devices, if you don't know, then it might create some hurdle. So you have to learn each and everything in order to become a good cardiologist. You are not becoming cardiologist to just to pass the exams.
Okay. Anonymous attendee keh rahe hain ji, Dr. Naveen, could you repeat the final slide of question and answer? Okay, ye presentation hum le lenge to aap fir baad mein dekh sakte hain.
Bilkul bilkul.
Dr. Ubaid pooch rahe hain ki how to differentiate ruptured sinus of Valsalva from PDA on auscultation?
अच्छा, रप्चर साइनस ऑफ वेसल्वा में भी कंटिन्यूस मर्मर होगा, लेकिन अब लाउडर कहाँ होगा? ये ओवर द लोअर प्रीकॉर्डियम, एक्सटर्नल एज लोअर प्रीकॉर्डियम पे, और इसकी फेजिक फ्लो होगा तो सिस्टोलिक या डायस्टोलिक में इंक्रीज साउंड होगी रादर देन कंटिन्यूस. होगा कंटिन्यूस मर्मर, बट यू बी अप्रिशिएटिंग द साउंड ऑफ मर्मर इंक्रीज इन इंटेंसिटी आइदर इन द सिस्टोल और इन द डायस्टोल. आई होप यू हैव गॉट इट.
ओके, ग्रेट. डॉक्टर आमिर रशीद कह रहे हैं सर काइंडली डिफरेंशियल वाली स्लाइड दोबारा डिस्कस कर लें. वो मैं आपको सर ओके वो मैं आपसे अभी कर लेंगे, भी आपके क्वेश्चंस कर लें, हो सकता है उसमें दोबारा ये हम रिपीट कर लें. सर नॉर्मस स्टैंडिंग कह रहे हैं सर काइंडली डू अपलोड प्रीवियस ऑल वेबिनार्स रिगार्डिंग ऑन एम एस सी फॉरम. ओके जी, ठीक, बिल्कुल सही है. Okay, what is the exact pressure difference? White pulse pressure ka pooch rahe hain, pressure difference kya hai? Like above 30 millimeter of mercury to mark this as a white pulse pressure. Matlab wo cut off puchna cha rahe hain ki kitna ho.
It's a range, 30 to 50 ka around. It's a range.
30 to 50 ke range hai.
Range
hai. Phir mean ho gaya phir 40.
Ji. It's above 50 is a white pulse pressure. Lekin again it depend upon the systolic pressure. Systolic pressure already low is 90. So then the diastolic pressure is 50, then it can be classified as the white pulse pressure. Having said that, if there is 120-80, it's normal. Again, 40, 30 to 50 is normal, providing the fact there is a normal blood pressure. If the systolic blood pressure are low, then definition changes, the range changes.
Dr. Ishwaq Ahmed pooch rahe hain, other than Eisenmenger, in which case device closure is contraindicated in PDA? मतलब पीडीए अगर आइजनमेंगर के साथ है तो फिर तो आपने नहीं लगाना डिवाइस क्लोज करना. उसके अलावा भी है कोई? उसके अलावा भी
हां, उसके अलावा इज अ स्मॉल पीडीए एसिम्प्टोमेटिक एंड मर्मर इज नॉट ऑडिबल, देन यू डोंट हैव टू क्लोज दैट पीडीए.
ओके 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 सर. और ये पूछ रहे हैं टेल मी वाइट पल्स प्रेशर वैल्यू इन मिलीमीटर ऑफ मर्करी. ये बात हो गई है उसके अंदर. और डॉक्टर सईद गयास अली पूछ रहे हैं कि विद इंक्रीजिंग पल्मोनरी हाइपरटेंशन द मर्मर गेट्स शॉर्टर इन ड्यूरेशन एंड समटाइम्स इज हर्ड लाइक अ पैन सिस्टोलिक मर्मर बट अदर साइंस शुड बी रिलाइड अपॉन इन सच केस.
सॉरी ऐसी बात की आवाज कट रही है, क्या कह रहे
हैं? ओके, मैं रिपीट करता हूं. वो कह रहे हैं कि जैसे पल्मोनरी हाइपरटेंशन इंक्रीज होती है ना पीडीए के केस में, तो मर्मर जो है वो शॉर्ट होना शुरू हो जाता है और इतना शॉर्ट हो जाता है कि सिर्फ सिस्टोलिक मर्मर सुनाई देता है.
In fact, if there is a sign, predominant sign of pulmonary hypertension, one cannot appreciate the underlying cause. It's not the case of PDA, even in the VSD, ASD, or coarctation of aorta. One, if the congenital heart disease, someone develop Eisenmenger syndrome or pulmonary hypertension, one won't be able to appreciate the underlying murmur.
Okay, okay. Simple question, what are the differentials of continuous murmur? I think इसको डिस्कस करने की जरूरत है.
ऑलरेडी हमने बता दिया डीडी.
हाँ, और ठीक है जी, सिस्टर डिफरेंस 15 मिलीमीटर मर्करी हो गया। सर्जरी वर्सेस डिवाइस क्लोजर, इसके बारे में सर भी कमेंट करें।
सर्जरी इज अ ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ चॉइस इन इन्फेंट्स और चिल्ड्रन, वाइल डिवाइस क्लोजर इन द ओल्डर चिल्ड्रन एंड एडल्ट्स। सो बेसिकली क्लासमेन, इफ यू समवन आस्क फ्रॉम द क्लासमेन इंडिकेशन इज द डिवाइस क्लोजर wherever suitable. European Society of Cardiology last year updated where, whenever and wherever suitable, you have to implant a device.
Okay.
While American Heart Association says if there is directing the child, you can go for surgery. Otherwise, for older children and adults, it's a device closure.
Okay. ठीक हो गया। Sir, kindly rediscuss. The asked questions in the exam regarding PDA that you shared in last slide. वो जो आपने आखिरी स्लाइड में कुछ क्वेश्चंस बताए हैं उनको जो पूछे आते हैं वो गए सर, उनको अगर आप एक दफा दोबारा गो थ्रू कर दें तो आई थिंक दिस विल बी आवर लास्ट क्वेश्चन। तो सर अगर आप उसमें गो थ्रू करना चाहें तो आई थिंक
अच्छा, दीज आर द इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस। What's a differential cyanosis and reverse differential cyanosis and what are their reasons? So differential cyanosis, again, I've already explained, if the upper body is pink and the lower body is blue, and reverse differential cyanosis or vice versa. So regarding causes, preductal coarctation of aorta with PDA, I'm talking about differential cyanosis now. Preductal coarctation of aorta with PDA, interrupted aortic arch and VSD with PDA. Regarding reverse differential diagnosis, cyanosis, it's a transposition of great artery with coarctation of aorta and PDA. What factors causes the functional and anatomical closure of ductus arteriosus? So there are three factors: thrombosis, intimal proliferations, and fibrosis in the subsequent weeks, which cause the functional and anatomical closure of the ductus arteriosus. Basically, these are the histological changes. What are the important risk factors for PDA? Already I explained high altitude, rubella infection, female gender, and genetic factors. Which condition depend upon the patency of PDA for survival? You have to make sure the PDA is open. So this is a hypoplastic left heart, preductal coarctation of aorta, and complete transposition of great arteries. Time period in which ductal arteriosus closes normally, already explained, 15 to 18 hours after birth. In preterm infant, you can wait for 1 year. In term infant, you can wait for 3 months. Association of PDA already explained, VSD, transposition of great arteries, and preductal coarctation of aorta, interrupted aorta. What's the common cause of heart failure in preterm infant is the PDA.
Sahi. A comment hai ji, Dr. Mariam Siddika keh rahi hai, very good. Well, concise talk. Thank you, Dr. Haseeb and Dr. Naveen. So, let me take a look if I have any other question for you, or we will just complications of device closure. Sir, kuch batana chahenge complications of device closure?
So basically, it's embolization. Aur ye bhi koi khatir khwa complication nahi hai. One can live with the device embolization. Or it can be sneered up. So this is basically the complication of device closure. Embolization is the main complication.
Okay. Amir Rashid, Dr. Amir Rashid keh rahe hain ki sir, very good session. Aur Dr. Babar Ikram hai ji, humare sahab keh rahe hain, hi Dr. Haseeb, good work. Keep it up. Hats off to your efforts. Thank you ji. Aur nicely explained by Dr. Naveen, thank you so much. So bahut sare comments the is tarah ke, thank you ji, aapki appreciation jo hai wo speaker ke liye badi zaruri hoti hai aur hamare liye bhi moderator ke liye bahut zaruri hoti hai. So I think we have no more questions left, so with this we will close our today's session. It has been a very healthy session. Bade zabardast kaam ki baat hai na, wo aapse share kar di gayi hai, sawal bhi bata diye hain aur जवाब भी आपको बता दिए. सो विद दिस आई विल अगेन थैंक डॉक्टर नवीन रॉय. सर बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया आपका, आपने इतने शॉर्ट नोटिस पे हमारे लिए टाइम निकाला.
इट्स ऑलवेज प्लेजर डॉक्टर हसीब. और इंशाल्लाह जब भी ज़रूरत थी तो वी विल हेल्प योर यंग कार्डियोलॉजिस्ट। और आपने जो इनिशिएटिव लिया, हैट्स ऑफ। यकीन करें वी हैवन प्रोवाइडेड द प्लेटफॉर्म, हम इधर उधर ही भटकते रहते थे पार्ट टू के लिए, मुझे याद है, लेकिन दिस इज अ गुड अपॉर्चुनिटी। और जो आपने वो सेशन एक कंडक्ट करवाया था इन विच डॉक्टर इलियास थे और बाकी सब थे, इन विच देवर शेयरिंग देयर एक्सपीरियंसेस, यही चीज़ें होती हैं जो इट विल हेल्प यू आउट इन पासिंग FCBS पार्ट टू। हर कोई पढ़ता है और हर कोई अपनी मेहनत करता है यहाँ तक पहुँचने में, बस एक थोड़ा सा क्लिक चाहिए होती है, और डॉक्टर हसीब ने ऑलरेडी आप लोगों को प्रोवाइड कर दिया है। एंड इंशाल्लाह अगर आप लोग अच्छा ऐसे ही पढ़ते रहेंगे तो डेफिनेटली यू विल ऑल पास।
इंशाल्लाह इंशाल्लाह हमारी कोशिश यही है कि सब जो है फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट में पास हो जाए। ऐसा होता तो नहीं है लेकिन कोशिश यही होती है कि सब फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट
हाँ
में पास हो जाए,
नहीं,
बाकी
अब
आपकी भी
इंशाल्लाह,
किस
हाँ अब चीज़ें चेंज हो रही हैं, तो इंशाल्लाह CPSP इज रियलाइजिंग कि भाई अब हमें थोड़ा इंटरनेशनल स्टैंडर्ड्स में आने, तो होपफुली अब ये है कि चीज़ें चेंज हो रही हैं।
बिल्कुल ठीक है। होप वो मैं कहा करता हूँ कि जी प्रिपेयर फॉर द वर्स्ट बट होप फॉर द बेस्ट।
बिल्कुल
सो इंशाल्लाह होप फॉर द बेस्ट। और थैंक यू सो मच डॉक्टर नवीन। आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक डॉक्टर प्रोफेसर जुबैर अकरम साहब फ्रॉम लाहौर फॉर हिज असिस्टेंस एंड थैंक्स टू हाइनून फार्मा फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग दिस जूम सेशन। और वी विल सी यू इन द नेक्स्ट वेबिनार वेरी सुन। सो ऑल ऑफ यू टेक केयर ऑफ योर सेल्फ एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर बींग विद अस। ओके सर, खुदा हाफिज़।
खुदा हाफिज़, अल्लाह हाफिज़।